I'm sitting at the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. Today I am going to take one of my favorite Simon and Garfunkel songs. I'm going to deconstruct it and then put it back together again in an interesting way. I've never played this song before, although I've listened to it a million times, and it's Homeward Bound by Simon and Garfunkel. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm just going to listen and maybe try and figure out what key it's in, what some of the chord progression is. That's nice.
I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination.
Right away, I was noticing kind of a descending motion in the bass. It starts on a B flat, then it goes to an A, and then to an A flat, and then to a G. And if you are a guitar player, or even if you're not, you should know guitarists don't like notes like B flat. Unless you're playing jazz or something. We like it to be super easy and folksy. So I know right now I'm gonna put my capo on 3 and play in G. I'm not sure if those are the chords yet, but those are the bass notes, and so much easier with capo. Okay, so it definitely goes G. Then it goes to some sort of D slash F sharp. And then right here, I think it just does like a D minor slash F sharp. And then the next chord is either an E minor or it's a C slash E. And so that's what I'm gonna be listening for now. I'm gonna go back to just the beginning. It's a little easier to hear with less of the band in.
I'm sitting at the railway station, got a ticket for my destination.
I think it's E minor. I'm also hearing this bass line going, which is really common in Travis picking, which Paul Simon did a lot of. That was like A minor to F to G to D of some kind. This D that I'm playing right now seems a little too high, but it's still some sort of D chord right there. Okay, so this part's tripping me out a little bit because I can hear the bass. The bass is going boom. But that would make me think that the next chord might be an A minor because the bass goes from G to A. There's only one way to find out. And all of a sudden, I'm not convinced on that E minor chord anymore. So we'll have to see. After listening to the song, I have a general idea of the chord progression and kind of the bass line that's happening. The thing I'm still initially confused about is I don't know if that chord with the E in the bass is an E minor or an C slash E, which I don't think it is, but I'm not ruling it out. Or it could be an E major, which is not in the key, but would sound pretty cool. Figure it out. stands my suitcase and darling. Every stop for a boy. So I don't really love this D chord at the end of the verse either, and I don't know why. And every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Need someone to comfort me. Need someone to comfort me. Need someone to... probably end up using a different D chord. They're not doing a D slash F sharp or a D slash A, but to get the bassy sound that I want, I'll probably end up going with that one or something kind of pretty like that. We'll see. All right, so I've officially figured out the way I'm going to play the chord progression. I'm not saying it's 100% correct, but it's just the way it sounds to me musically. And now I'm going to go see if I can grab that cool little riff that happens at the beginning. Right off the bat, I heard thirds and fourths and some hammer-ons and pull-offs. And since we're in a G, I'm going to start with a G. Yep, right there. That was not it, but it was kind of close. Let's listen again. Okay, goes to a chord I wasn't quite expecting. I want to listen again and see if there's anything cool that the drums are doing or that the vocal harmonies are doing or a different guitar part or anything that's cool in the song that sometimes it's easy to miss the first time or even the 100th time you've listened to a song, but there's all these cool things that happen. So I'm going to be listening really intently to the background and see if there's anything special I want to add into the way I'm playing it. I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. That was one of the things. I've listened to the song 100 times, and I don't know if I've ever noticed that little riff right there. Okay, so I'm definitely going to put that in there. It's such a unique thing. I don't know how I'm going to do it yet because it's kind of awkward and hard, but it's never stopped me before. I kind of like how in the chorus, it just turns into like a country song. It's been this really beautiful kind of melancholy thing, but then in the chorus you hear this. It's not the exact bass line that's happening, but that's what it feels like to me. It's just like a country jam band. The way the drums change, the way the guitar changes. I'll let you listen to that one more time. There's another one of those background guitar parts. It's like I know that I've enjoyed it before, but I've never really noticed it was there. It's just going back and forth between a D and an E. Something like that. I think it does a little bit more here in a second. Every day is an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. Then it does kind of a almost Spanish-y. So at this point, I've given myself kind of a task. I want to take some of those cool fills and country bass lines that I was hearing and insert them into one guitar part, which sometimes I can do in my head, but it always goes a lot faster if I just write it down. So that's probably the next thing I'm going to do. I don't know if that's totally right. To be honest, it's pretty close. And usually, I'm not going to lie, if you guys weren't watching me right now, I'd just leave it like that. And I might end up leaving it like that. But let's listen to the rhythm one more time, see if there's something that I missed. All right, so that is the stripped down bass line. It's very boring by itself. But once you're singing over it, it'll actually be kind of a cool dynamic to have a verse that's a little more stripped down, because we're going to do plenty of picking later on in the song. That is a lot of work. I am probably going to fast forward a lot of what I just did because it's busy work. It's not all fun and games, but hopefully it's going to end up being really pretty when it's all said and done. But that's the kind of grind, is after you get this vision in your head and then you just have to make it happen. Okay, so this is going to be my performance I just put together over the past couple of hours. It will probably be full of mistakes, but my goal is just to give you a general idea of what this would sound like and hopefully give you more of an appreciation for all of the different parts of this really amazing song. So here is Homeward Bound by Simon and Garfunkel. I'm sitting at the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. On a tour of a one-night stand, my suitcase and guitar in hand. Every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound, I wish I was. Homeward bound, home when my thoughts escape, and home when my music's playing, home where my love lies waiting silently for me. And every day's an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. And each town looks the same to me, the movies and the factories. And every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be homeward bound. I wish I was homeward bound. Home where my thoughts escape, and home where my music's playing, home where my love lies waiting silently for me. Tonight I'll sing my songs again, I'll play the games and pretend. But all my words come back to me in shades of mediocrity, like emptiness and harmony. I need someone to comfort me. Homeward bound, I wish I was. My thoughts escaping, home where my music's playing, home where my love lives waiting silently for me, silently for me. All right, guys, that was my first take. It was what it was. Several weird things happened, but that's all part of it. And thank you so much for hanging out with me today, and I'll see you next time.